Hello. How's everyone doing? You okay? Good to see you. Nice amount of comments coming in already. Great. Craig was first. He was at least 15 minutes early into the show today. Love that. Dedication. Casper's here. Great to see you again, mate. I love that bit of B-roll you showed me earlier on that you sent over. That looked absolutely sick. I really look forward to seeing that YouTube video. Who else is here? Miss Cross. Mrs. Cross? Laura. Hi, Laura. Thank you for the flapjacks. They are sick. So nice. Love them. I've already had three. I've had three. Sorry. Maggie, how you doing? My mum's here. Alex is here. Thank you so much for dropping them around, man. I appreciate that. Obviously, we are... Laura's distributing cookies safely and flapjacks safely. We're not, like, just meeting up willy-nilly and eating cookies and in the street and stuff. It's all safe. Has everyone had a good day? Michael, how you doing? I've had a really good day today, actually. Thank you. I've been working on my brother's video, which should be released soon, I guess. And James will be with us really soon. I'm going to probably just wait till a few more people come in on the comments, and then I'll be bringing him on. We did sound check at about 5 and it sounded incredible. So I'm looking forward to hear him play a handful of songs for us tonight. I'll be honest, I haven't had a chance to pick up the guitar today, so I have no idea what I'm going to play. But I am working on that new material. I did give myself an hour of time just to start building the track for the song that I'm going to release next week, potentially. But I did mention it yesterday, I kind of dropped myself in it. And said that I would be putting a song out. So I guess I've got to do it now. So I made a start on that today, as well as editing all day. All this feels strange and untrue, and I won't waste a minute without you. My bones ache, my skin feels cold, and I'm getting so tired and so old. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. 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 I want so much to open your eyes, 'cause I need you to look into mine. Get up, get out, get away from me now, 'cause I need him all now. Da 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 da, shit. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes.
And I won't waste a minute without you.
That serves me right, doesn't it, for not having a bit of a practice this afternoon. I had to do a bit of my own off-the-cuff writing in that and add my own lyrics in. So apologies for that. How did you go with the Dunwells cover? Well, yesterday I got asked to do the Dunwells song, and I did a little bit of it yesterday on the live and kind of butchered it. And I don't think I'm going to do it again today, because, as I say, I've not really picked up the guitar. Yeah, seamless, huh? Yeah, absolutely seamless. It's all right. You're in for a treat anyways. It's not really about me, is this? I mean, obviously, I like to play songs, and I appreciate you liking me to play a few songs here and there. But it's more about showcasing and catching up with other musicians and showing you new talent and stuff like that. So, yeah, I think I'm just going to jump right into introducing you to James, and he'll totally redeem the show with his catalogue of music that he'll be playing today. All right, here we go. Because in fact, I think there's quite a few new people in the comments today. So if you're here for James, just give us a thumbs up, and then we can sort of pick you out and welcome you to the family, I guess. Right, here we go. Here's James. Hey, man.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
Very good. I'm all right. Well, yeah, I'm all right. I'm glad I got through the song just about. But yeah, I'm doing all right, man. Yeah, it's good to see you, man. How have you been? How are you keeping? All right?
Yeah, I'm okay. A lot of people are getting bored with lockdown, but I'm just doing all sorts.
Keeping busy.
Bit of everything. Lots of music. Reading, watching loads of programs, films, playing video games, building Lego.
Very, very busy then. Nice. Very busy. So, overall, you're quite enjoying the whole lockdown experience then, making the best of it, I guess.
Yeah, I'm not too bad really, because we can still do exercise. So I can go out on runs and bike rides.
Yeah, yeah.
Biggest downside for me, I think, is like not being able to see family and stuff. And then where I work in Huddersfield, we're kind of like a family there as well. So yeah. It's a bit sad not seeing people.
Yeah, but I think there's no end of technology these days, isn't there, now, where you can FaceTime and, you know, Zoom call and do all that sort of stuff and jump on a call with, you know, groups of people, family or work colleagues and stuff like that, and catch up that way. So I think, you know, we're making the best of it in that way, aren't we, really?
Yeah, a lot of people doing Zoom online pub quizzes.
Yeah, I've seen a few of them dotting about. There's a guy called Simon Walker. He does a Facebook music quiz. I think it's once a week or every other week or something, and he plays like songs in between. It's really good. It's really cool. So you say you've been doing a bit of music and stuff here and there. Are you writing? Are you just learning new covers?
I haven't learned any covers for a while. A bit of music. I'm trying to re-record some stuff that I recorded a while ago. That's not very good quality, but I've got like better sample packs, better gear and stuff now. So that's happening.
Did you start that before lockdown, or is that something that you've just started building up, like during lockdown, that kind of thing, using
Amazon? Yeah, trying to kind of, you know, think, oh, if I've got a bit more time and I'm not going out to work, then
yeah,
I'll try and do something like that. But it's very easy to, like I said, I've got a lot of different interests, even just in the house, so it's very easy to get distracted just doing something else.
Yeah, absolutely. So what is this something that you're planning on releasing, or is it just for, like, well, because is it material that you've already released that you say you're re-recording, or have you kind of held on to it and not put it out yet and you're wanting to perfect it?
A bit of both, really. I've put material online that's just on SoundCloud or YouTube and things like that.
Okay.
The big plan is to try and put it together as like a demo and release it properly produced. But I just want to kind of just get music out there, see if people like it. You know, even if it's just a home recording and it sounds like a home recording.
Yeah, yeah. Just kind of get a feel for it.
Yeah. I tend to try and go spend a lot of time on stuff. So even if I just do Instagram videos, rather than usually just doing a guitar and singing on my phone,
yeah,
I try and produce it a bit and put a lot of stuff on it.
Yeah, I've seen. Yeah. And then you do the multicam thing and and you do like almost like the one man band type video where you play every instrument. It looks really good and it sounds great always. So that's cool, is that? So you play various instruments, so is it you dabble a bit in piano, a bit of keys and guitar and
I've always played guitar, grew up playing classical guitar in school. I think one of my classical guitar buddies is on here actually. I think I saw his name, S. Russell. We used to do some flamenco stuff in school. I went and did that at uni and I still do it, but I do a lot more kind of contemporary guitar, electric and stuff like that, bass guitar. Got a piano here. It doesn't get that much use. I play a little bit, but playing guitar for 15 years, I can pick up and play anything pretty much, where I sit at the piano and have to learn. And I kind of think,
it's quite frustrating,
I'll just go play guitar because I can actually do that well.
Especially when we were kind of touched on it earlier on, because I was saying, like, I do not play piano really at all, but I managed to be able to rattle out enough to be able to correct it all in MIDI. It's quite funny, really, like technology takes over and it helps, and I suppose maybe in some respects it's good and everything, but definitely is giving me no reason to actually learn it properly.
Yeah.
I just go, right, okay, I bashed out enough of the chords to be able to correct it now.
Yeah,
cheating, I guess.
I find sometimes you can get carried away with MIDI if anyone understands MIDI, where you can input notes and you think, oh, that chord sounds really nice, and realize you've got like a 9-note chord on the piano.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's really hard to play because it spans like too wide range or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Just because it sounds nice in MIDI.
I do the same with MIDI drums as well. Sometimes I start adding in like extra arms, you know, so like... Yeah. You hit cymbals and toms and snares and everything all at the same time just because it sounds really full. And then you're like, well, no one can actually play that. So that's a bit dumb, isn't it? But anyway, that's neither here nor there, is it? That's cool that you're planning on releasing some new music. And is that like on the horizon, or is it, you know, a way off?
I'm at the stage where it's like, if I'm going to sit down at, I'm thinking, right, am I going to start working on a new tune, which is going to be a long process, or am I going to go back through and re-record or remix, you know, a previous song to try and make it better, re-record the vocals or whatever. So it's just deciding which one to do first. I do have a couple of songs that I like, and when I listen to them now, I think it sounds a bit rubbish as a production point of view. I work down in a local studio literally down the road from me, and we produce music for media, for television adverts, you know, anything, and it's got to be really professionally produced. So when you listen to their stuff and then I listen to my home stuff, it's just so like far away from that.
Yeah. So do you find you're picking up things, techniques and stuff, then working there?
Yeah, definitely, because these guys have been doing this for, 20 years, and it's their livelihood. That is their job Monday to Friday. They're writing music, recording music, and they put it out there. It's really good fun. You find a lot of techniques, and because they know so much as well, if I ever have a question about gear or anything, or on something on Logic, or what's the shortcut for this, you'll just know.
Yeah.
They'll know everything.
That's good. That's good to have, such a close network of people that you're able to help to improve your craft and stuff. That's awesome. I reckon we should jump into your first song if you're about ready.
Yeah.
Are you going to start off with covers or original, or what's the thing for you tonight?
This one's a cover, this first one.
Cool.
All I'll say is this is from the well-known film Toy Story.
Banger is this song.
This one.
Absolute tune. Right, I'll hand you over, man.
Thank you.
Together we can see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, bigger and stronger too. Well, none of them will ever love you the way I do, just me and you. And as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny, 'cause you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend. In me.
Yeah, what a banger. Love that song, man.
Feel good.
Yeah, man. Feel good vibes. Great. So do you do that with the band as well, or do you just do that solo?
No, I don't do that one with the band. I tend to do that solo. It works quite well.
You do like other like Pixar, Disney-esque kind of stuff, like the Jungle Book thing, and I don't,
yeah, that's.
Like, so I wondered if that's a running theme with the band and you guys.
I've done that with me and Tom's singer. I've done that with him when we do duo stuff, because it's quite relaxed. But our band, we try and really kind of keep it upbeat and quite mental, but not like really rocky and loud and everything. It's more just very enthusiastic.
Yeah, that's cool, man. So how is the band, how obviously has that it will have ground to a slight halt just whilst this is going on, but beforehand Oop. Sorry about that. Beforehand, you were quite busy and stuff, weren't you?
Yeah. Pretty much every weekend. For anyone who doesn't recognise me, I'm in the Good Citizens, local Bradford band, with a band who did Take Me Home, the Bradford City Anthem. That's what we're best known for around these parts. but yeah, pretty much every weekend, gigging every weekend or twice a weekend, lots of weddings and stuff. That's taken a big hit. People are having to rearrange the wedding. Even I'm supposed to be getting married in July, and we're on the kind of cusp of literally trying to make the decision whether we have to rearrange it or not. But yeah, we're pretty successful as a band, really. It's pretty good, and it helps out for my solo stuff, because some people have come to watch me, my solo gigs, off the back of, you know, the band or seeing the band. And yeah, it works. It works really well for that.
You guys have got so much energy and just such good feel good band, and I can see why you've had the success you've had and you continue to have it, kind of thing. Because I mean, you're just an absolute like ball of energy between the three of you. And
I think it's just... because our lead singer's an 8-year-old boy stuck in a man's body.
He's so funny. He's hilarious. Yeah, when you guys came into the studio, it was a laugh a minute. When you came in and did that session, Tom just feels like he's ready to burst with energy. It's so funny, it's great. But yeah, I can see obviously why you guys are so popular and stuff. It's great because you're quite like chilled, and I like the fact that you've got like the best of both. Like I love the fact that you play your really chilled and your delicate kind of music with your, sort of just more acoustic versions of stuff, but then you've still got your high energy songs. I think there's a good balance in the band, especially vocally as well, because you've both got totally different vocal ranges.
Yeah, people mention that a lot, because I'm very kind of, I always get stuck with the female parts if there's other female songs.
I have no idea why.
And then Tom's kind of big boomy loud, powerful, and then I'm more very kind of soft and pure kind of. But it does work, doesn't it? Because if I was like Tom, it'd be too much. It'd be so
it'd be
much.
A lot, yeah. There's enough of Tom.
Yeah, for a lifetime.
No, it's great. It's cool, especially like the harmonies and stuff are always on point, and it works really well. So that's cool. And each of you have like, you know, lots of talent when it comes to being able to arrange a song and make it sound really full with just a stripped back drum kit and one guitar and then your two vocals. I love the fact that you kind of know when the right time is to like build it up and bring it down, and there's lots of dynamics despite there being not very many musicians in the band. I think you do that really well. So
yeah, we have to like, As the only guitarist for me, when we think about doing a new song, like there's so many songs sometimes Tom or Jamie, our drummer, will suggest, and then I'll think, I can't do it because that song is awesome, you know, proper massive song. Or it's got so many layers or something, and I'm the only guitar.
It's just so popular, man. It's
Bixby loves me. what was I saying? Yeah. I have to adjust a lot. I can't usually do a guitar part, or I don't really like do a guitar solo our gigs, because there's no music if I start playing a guitar solo. There's no bass or anything. So a lot of the time it's chords and then adding things with chords, or just using the voice to make layers and things.
Yeah, I like also you've started bringing in like other elements, like a bit of technology in there with the pedal board to be able to bring in the bass digitally, kind of thing. But it's still all 100% live, you know, like still playing, like it's just like bringing it down a slightly lower tone and stuff. It just sounds much fuller, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's good. It's really good. Someone's commented on your artwork behind you, the wooden.
Oh yeah, board. This was created by my fiance Sky. She's watching. I think she'll be Miss Cross. Yeah, she's talking about Pikachu.
Nice.
She created this for.
Also, she made her own account for this. She thought she was logging into yours. We were like, yeah. James Fearnley has entered the game. But you're there.
Yeah.
But yeah. No, that's cool. Yeah, so she did that herself. That's amazing.
Yeah, and I've got my little matching guitar as well.
Very good. She made that as well?
No, I made this.
No way.
No, it was one of those sets where you just buy a little craft set. You know, you pull all the pieces out, slot them together, and then I just painted it. And I always really wanted to strap this colour. So I painted it that colour. And I thought if I ever get a strat one day, it's that colour. And then a few months later, I got this one, which I'm going to be playing at some point.
Nice. Very good. That'd be perfect. That'd be an ideal size guitar for my brother, actually. It's good size. Good size is that one. Nice. If he's watching, he'll
I need some strings on it now.
Yeah. Do you want to play your second song on that note? Yep. Are you going to be doing an original or a cover again, or what?
I'll do another cover now.
Sweet. This song, if it's the same one you did during soundcheck, as saying, it just reminds me of the open mic days. You used to play this song at Cooper's. And I think I'm pretty sure that was the first time, like, we properly met, kind of thing, and got to know each other and stuff through open mics.
And I remember your guitar. I was like, hey, he's got a hole in his guitar. How much does he play his guitar underneath?
This one.
Yeah,
that one. Yeah, it's probably just because of bad technique more than the amount I play it. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. You play this song really nicely.
Yeah, this song, I don't often do this at gigs because it's an awkward tuning. You have to change all the tuning on the guitar. Tune one of the strings quite high. If you did it really fast, it'd just snap.
Right.
So, and it'd require taking two guitars. So some people, you know, used to ask, oh, are you doing this song? No, not tonight. It's just an effort.
Yeah,
so I do it for this because I do really like the song, and I was supposed to be seeing this artist in 4 days, but it's been rescheduled to next year
now.
Yeah.
Oh man,
for the second time actually. We were going to see him in January. We were going to see him in Luxembourg of all places last year in January, because that was like the closest way to see him, and he cancelled that tour.
I wonder why.
Just personal reasons or something like that. And then the second time
Amy's got it. Sorry, she's guessed the song, but great. Sorry, you were going to say then the second time.
The second time, which was going to be in 4 days, that's now postponed. So one day we will see him.
One day. Yeah, man, definitely worth a watch. Right, I'll hand you over, and then we can talk more about this artist or whatever.
Okay.
See, if anyone's got any questions in the comments that you'd like to ask James, please get them in and I will relay them over best I can. And yeah, here we go. Are you about ready, man?
Yeah, I think so.
Cool. Take it away. My, 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 my.
staring at the sink of blood and crushed veneer. So my love to wreck it all, cut out all the ropes and let me fall. My, 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 my. Right in this moment, the saddest of. And I told you to be patient, and I told you to be kind. I told you to be balanced, and I told you to be fine. In the morning I'll be with you, but it'll be a different kind. I'll be holding all the tickets, and you'll be owning all the fights. Come on, skinny love, what happened here? Suck along the hope in light brazier. My, 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 my. Sun and lotus fall so slow on the sphere. Not told you to be patient, and I told you to be fine. I told you to be balanced, and I told you to be kind. Now all your love is wasted, and then who the hell was I? Now I'm breaking at the bridges, and at the end of all your lines. Who will love you and who will fight? Who will fall far behind? Who will love you? Who will fight? Who will fall far behind?
That was something else. Brilliant. Do you know any other Bon Iver stuff?
Yeah. Do you remember I used to do Flume? Do you remember that one?
You did.
Yeah. I haven't done that for ages. I think last time I did that was when you and your brother ran that video session in Otley.
Rocker, yeah, that was the start of Assembly Point, pretty much.
Yeah, but that one's another high one as well, and I don't think my voice was up to scratch that day. But yeah, that I pretty much only do them two, really, I think. I used to do, there was one called Restacks from his first album.
All right, yeah.
As well,
mate, honestly, you do it justice. It sounds great.
Thank you.
I almost think you should just keep playing all night, to be fair. It's just wicked. That's really good, man. Really impressed. So where would you say you sort of take your main influence from? Is that the kind of genre of music that you take all your influence when it comes to writing originals?
A little bit of that. To be fair, it might become popular for some people, but Ed Sheeran as well. Mm. He's kind of...
You can't deny that he can write a song, eh? He's a good songwriter. He's solid.
One of my favourite artists, I think, of all time is Paolo Nutini.
Okay.
And when I listen to his stuff, it kind of get a bit of an influence from him with the music and stuff. And my voice is nothing like his. I love doing covers of his songs. I cover loads of his songs. But yeah, I'm complete opposite kind of style of voice. But yeah, Paolo Nutini, Bon Iver were always the kind of two that I'd try and, you know, think of a bit of influence from.
Your voice definitely suits the Bon Iver, because you don't sing falsetto, but it's almost falsetto, sound sort of thing.
It's too low for me to do falsetto. I've got this middle voice, like the chest and then the middle voice, so it kind of hurts if you sing like a lot with the Good Citizens. I'll sing a lot of that high stuff. I can't sing falsetto because it's too quiet. I'll get drowned out. But it sounds like a really loud falsetto then. So it kind of drops rather than the chest or in the head. It's like, can't describe it. It's like there.
So is that your go-to vocal then? Or do you have a lower range normally as well?
Yeah, I do. When I do my solo gigs, I do a good mix because it's just me and my guitar. I can control like the volume of stuff. So I'll do some Johnny Cash at my solo gigs. You probably wouldn't expect after I just did that song. But yeah, I quite like singing kind of lower end stuff, Elvis, that type of stuff.
I'll be honest, I think I've only really properly heard you sing in that range.
Yeah.
Not like the higher range sort of thing, and I always thought that was your go-to sort of thing. I didn't realize, obviously, you know, everyone has different you know, spectrums and stuff, but at the same time I thought that was kind of your go-to vocal. Was that something that came after, or is that something you taught yourself and learned afterwards, or was that the first thing you started learning when it came to singing?
I genuinely think it was listening to Bon Iver and then hearing that song, and I didn't know how to really go into a head voice.
Yeah.
So it was still really weak and thin. I mean, my head voice is still quite weak unless I'm singing very high. I can do the really high, but I can't do the low stuff. And I tried singing along to him, and I remember really the top of my voice.
Because he's more falsetto though, isn't he?
Yeah. So when I listen to him now, he's actually doing his falsetto. I'm doing like my whatever my middle or chest kind of is.
Yeah, but you're singing full like, I'm not a music, don't know like terminology and stuff, but you're singing in full voice when he's doing a falsetto.
Yeah.
But you thought originally he was just doing it.
Yeah, because I didn't really know. I think it was about 16, 17 when I discovered that him, and I was listening to all his stuff and all of his songs are the same, and I thought, oh, I really want to try and do that. And I remember I did Skinny Love a couple of gigs the octave lower,
yeah,
because I thought I can't sing that high, and then I just remember trying to sing along to it and pushing my voice and stuff, and then the way I've just sung since being in the Good Citizens, I don't really get a chance to sing low because I need to cover the higher parts. So you kind of, that's, yeah, kind of
just happened.
That's my go-to thing kind of. When I do my solo stuff, I do a big range. I try, you know, lower verses, higher chorus or something.
Would it be putting you on the spot if you maybe rattled through a bit of that Cash song, the Johnny Cash song?
I could have a bit of a go of a Johnny Cash song.
Well, someone's just asked, that's all. Someone's put in the comments.
I need to get the lyrics and stuff, which I probably do have here. Yeah, I can have a go if you want.
Yeah, man, I think we've got time to still get you, because I really want to hear your original material as well. I want to hear that in full, because during soundcheck that sounded incredible. Is the original song that you started playing during soundcheck?
Yeah.
Is that something you've released already, or is that new?
Yeah, that was one that was mentioning about. I've released it, but it's not that good quality. It's a bit quiet, and the piano sounds a bit MIDI. It's a very piano-based tune.
Did say, yeah, yeah. I remember
But it works. It works on guitar enough to do it.
Yeah, it sounded really cool. But yeah, I'd be interested to hear this, and then
right, let's have a go on this. I would usually do this on my Strat. It's got a good pickup sound for it, but I'll just play it on this guitar.
Yeah. I'll just make you full screen and let you do your thing, man.
Cool. Okay.
So if anyone wants to get any questions in before we finish this evening, we've still got a bit of time left, so get any questions into the comments. If you have anything you want to ask James, then please just drop them in the comments and I'll relay them. I think we've been for a bit of a treat with this one. Let's see how we go.
Okay, I did not expect to be playing this one. We'll see how it goes.
You've got it.
Excuse any lyrics or mishaps.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day is through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Oh. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right. Because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your side. You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Oh, I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Because you're mine, I walk the line.
Yeah. Totally different.
Yeah.
Like, pulls apart. You wouldn't have even thought it was the same vocalist. It's so strange to hear, like, how crazily broad the vocal range is. That's amazing.
Thank you.
Sounds great either way, man. I like it.
It's a fun song, that, isn't it?
Yeah, man. So, there was a question asking, how did you get into music in the first place? In general, I guess.
I did guitar lessons at school. Started at the end of primary school doing, you know, basic classical guitar, the typical stuff, just playing on one string. And then got to Beckford School, my secondary school, and I had a really good guitar teacher, Mr. Bromhead, Rob Bromhead he's called. He's based up in Bildon. He really good jazz guitarist, but he taught me classical guitar all the way till grade 8. Did did all my grades, went to do that at uni. As I got to uni, so that was about 9 years ago, I started uni, started to get a bit interested in singing a bit more. I always sung a little bit, and I did, you know, singing at school a bit, but I never really liked singing in front of people much. I had a weird thing though, it's still the same. I don't really, if there were two people in this room, two strangers, and they said sing a song, I'd be a bit like, a bit shy about it. But if there were 1,000 people, I'd be fine.
Yeah, yeah. You kind of get, because it's much easier to impress 1,000 people. You know, if 50% of 1,000 people liked you, it still feels good. If 50% of 2 people only liked you,
yeah,
you've got one person not liking you stood in front of you, and he's just. But yeah, I feel exactly the same way when it comes to performing and stuff. So you mentioned obviously you got into music by learning the guitar, but like what was the initial thing? Like, was there a type of band or was there something that you growing up that made you go, I want to be a guitar player, or was it just encouraged through school?
Yeah, it was. I'd like some cool story about it where, you know, you snuck out of your house to go to a gig and then, but no, it was literally, my mum just said, you know, oh, we'll do guitar lessons, I think. I can't remember that far because I think it was 10, 9 or 10. And I just went to do them at school and I thought it was okay. In the first year, and the second year was okay. And then when I got to high school, it was really good because the teacher was great then. So I wasn't really into bands and stuff. I didn't really listen to much music. My mum and my sister have always been proper musical people, you know, Sound of Music and all sorts. And so I never really listened to bands and things. I knew a lot of songs from musicals and stuff until I got to like 15, 16, and then just started listening to stuff. But I've always been the type of person who listens to songs, you know, singles or things rather than a whole album.
Yeah, yeah. I think you're about the same age as me, aren't you?
You're 30? 26.
Oh, shit. You're a hell of a lot younger than me. Oh. No, it's because I've just thought, because I'm the same really. I think I was the back end of like albums and more playlists, like, so I would make like a series of songs to make up an album, or like, you know, stuff that I'd prefer to listen to as opposed to buying an album and listening to it throughout. I mean, there was the odd album, there are a few albums out there that I did listen to like front to back kind of thing, and but I think, yeah, I don't think we're too far removed from listening to more singles and what's like, you know, the song that the artist is pushing the most, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, Sky is on it, giving your socials out, and she's in the comments. She's great.
She came in and gave me a note.
Give, I know, did you?
And your mic is blowing a bit. Maybe you want to go further away.
Great. That's good. That's really sweet of her. So is she is it quite a creative house to live in then? Obviously she's doing art and stuff.
Well,
that must be pretty.
She's really pretty good cool at making things, you know, crafts and things. Like this Christmas, she made.
Dinner.
She made
sorry.
She made like coffee, you know, spa scrubs, stuff like that. You know, like a face scrub, a face mask thing.
Oh yeah.
She made them for some people this Christmas.
That's amazing.
From coffee, I think. She makes stuff like this, craft stuff for wood. Obviously for our wedding in July, there's so much stuff that we've got from just bought like old pair of ladders or something, and she's just crafted things together.
Very cool.
It's quite funny. I'm inside at the computer doing something, and she's hammering outside in the garden.
Yeah, that's cool. Oh, that's amazing. Oh, that's cool. I think it must be nice to like have, you know, all types of creativity going on in the house. You know, I know she's into, she's very supportive of your music and that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
Which is really cool, man. So, maybe you should collaborate together when you release your artwork. You should do some sort of, I don't know.
Yeah.
Album box, cover. CD case.
Yeah.
Type album artwork.
T-shirt designs.
Yeah. T-shirts. Yeah. There's definitely some collaboration in the horizon there. Very good, man. My wife's also just pointed out that, because you mentioned about your age, there was a time where I was close to 30 and I still was convinced I was 24 for a long time. So anyone that would be like, ask, just, you know, like, I'd be out with her work friends and just catching up and stuff and doing the small talk and all that kind of stuff. And they'd be like, oh, so what do you do? And I'm like, oh, I run a studio and I'm sort of self-employed musician, all that kind of crap. And I'd be like, oh, how old are you? And I'd be like, 24. And Amy nearly choked on a naan bread. She was like, you're bloody 28 years old, man. And, so anyhow, but now I'm 31 and I'm past it now. Anyhow, hello darkness, my old friend.
Yeah, there's no anyway, way dude. Getting 30 and 20 mixed up now, is there?
Sky says she wears the trousers. Love it.
Turning into a very personal stream.
Yeah, sorry. Also, I don't. Have you been doing the NHS clap thing? Because I've forgot the last. I'm going to be honest. I forgot the last two times, and I'm going to make a real effort to do it this time. Because I feel like all my neighbours think we're like devil worshippers or something for not doing it.
We did it once, and the only people on the street, pretty much.
Right. Okay. I'm gonna go all out tonight and try to do three weeks worth of applauding, because as I say, we missed it the last two times. So that's a reminder for anyone else that's doing it, and also just to reassure Amy that I will be in on time. So I think. In that case, I think, do you want to play your original song, and then we'll just sort of have a bit of a sign off and further chat, and if there's anything left to say sort of thing. But yeah, I've really enjoyed having you on the show, man. It's been really good fun.
Good. I've enjoyed it, yeah.
Right, man. I'll hand you over to everyone, and you just play your original. Take it away.
Yeah. It's the first time I've ever actually played this song for anyone. Properly. It's going to be funny if I forget the lyrics to my own song.
Spend the days hand in hand and side by side. When we were strong and we won all the wars, we'd play along with this silly game of life. But then time moved on. All was lost for those years, but you fought your way through the fears, and you came back home. You came back home like an angel. We grow, let us show what we can do. And in the end, we'll just turn around and smile. And as time moves on, a love shall grow over the years. And we'll fight our way through the fears. No, we'll blowing in light. Now we found our home. We found our home. So like an angel blowing in light. When we are old and we've told all our tales, find our way to the place where it all began.
Yes, mate.
Thank you. Woo.
Isn't it a bit strange doing live streaming, eh? Just get like a golf clap at the end of it. That's great, mate. Really good work, man. You're getting a lot of love in the comments and stuff.
Oh, good.
So you should, if you get a chance to check out, just have a read through them at the end of the stream and stuff. And hopefully you've gained a few new followers and stuff and whatnot. I've really enjoyed having you on the show. Honestly, mate, you're so talented and like you're just genuinely nice guy as well, so it's always good to have someone like that on the show, because it just makes for a much better show sort of thing. So thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks to all the viewers as well, leaving all the nice comments, positive comments.
Yes,
claps, I think. Can't see
properly. Yeah, there's plenty of claps, although that might be a reminder for me to clap for the NHS soon as well. So So do you want, is there any final words or anything you want to sort of say, or just a sign off or anything?
If you can, please click, through to my socials. I use Facebook a lot. I'm starting to use YouTube a bit more. Please check out my band as well. I always plug my band, The Good Citizens. I try and post a lot of stuff on Instagram as well, just little videos and whatnot. Thank you.
Great. Thank you again, man, for coming on. And, if you just hang on 2 minutes, I'm just going to sign off and I'll speak to you a bit after we finish the show. All right. Just
cool. Bear with me.
Thanks again, James. Cheers. Thanks so much, guys, for tuning in once again. You continue to blow my mind for coming in and tuning in and watching my mug every single night. It doesn't go unnoticed, and I'm extremely grateful for that. And, I appreciate you showing so much love and support to my guests every single night. If you are new here, please consider subscribing to the channel. If you're not new here and you haven't subscribed to the channel, what are you doing? If you've already subscribed to the channel, thank you very much. I am I really appreciate it. Thank you. Right, I'm going to go show my appreciation to the NHS because, as I say, I forgot the last couple of times. So if you haven't already, then maybe you should go do that. Okay. Good night, everyone.